So plants are cool.
August, you want to show them this?
Medicinal purposes.
Number one, this plant is edible.
It's poisonous.
You would die.
The plant that killed Socrates.
And I know that because I do know a lot of cool plants, but I also know how to group them into similar categories in my head. Now today, I'm going to show you how to group most flowering plants into two different categories.
Monocots and dicots.
Today, we have a whole bunch of flowering plants that we're going to plant.
By flowering plants, I'm talking about the angiosperms, which are any plants with flowers. And those are different from the gymnosperms, like pine trees, the mosses, the ferns, and all of the other primitive plants.
Every one of these flowering plants we got can be divided into one of two categories, either a monocot or a dicot.
So here's the backstory. For flowering plants, biologists had finally divided them up into two groups, the monocots and dicots, the members of which tended to share similar features.
So here are the features we most commonly use.
Monocots like this lily are usually in multiples of three.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Dicots have petals generally in multiples of 4 or 5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Monocots typically have parallel veins, while dicots are net veined. If you pull up a monocot, most of the time it'll have these fibrous, spreading, or they call them adventitious roots. While the taproot, that's classic dicot. Stems. Cut the stem of a monocot in cross section, and you'll see something like this. Vascular bundles scattered all around. While in dicots, they're usually at the edge. Cotyledons. This refers to parts in the seed. Monocots, also known as monocotyledons, means one cotyledon in the seed. And dicots, like this bean, have two.
Okay, so there's about 250,000 species of flowering plants in the world. And with the five characters that I just showed you, about 75% of those have been classified as dicots, and about 23% have been classified as monocots. What that means is there's about 2% that don't fit the classification so well.
So recently, they've kind of revised our understanding of flowering plants. We think the evolutionary tree looks a bit like this. You see, early on, a few groups broke off. And then, other small groups came off of that. In the end, the monocots are classified here, and the dicots are classified here. But, other than the water lily relatives and the magnolia relatives, which contain most of that other 2% of flowering plants, the rest are still monocots and dicots.
Okay, so now go out and see if you can identify those plants. If you like what we're doing, of course we got more videos up here to watch, and you can subscribe to our feed.